look at all these goodies. Parents, this is a segment just for you. A lot of folks have already sent their kids back to school, of course, and sometimes packing their lunch can be the morning's biggest setback. It's easy to throw a bunch of unhealthy, easy things in their lunches, call it a day, but we've got Judy Nicasio, who's a certified nutritionist from Rejuvenet, here to show us that it's just as easy and fast to pack a healthy lunch.
It absolutely is.
We have to go healthy. You know, I know it's so easy to throw in a ready-made PB&J full of bad stuff, but right. In these days, so many schools have peanut allergy, have to be peanut-free.
Yeah, so everything today in today's segment is gluten-free, dairy-free, and
wow.
nut-free.
Okay.
So this is all healthy, and you don't have to worry about that.
And will the kids eat it?
And the kids will eat it because it's yummy.
Okay, very good. I'm ready for all these ideas. I'm taking notes.
So over here we have this lovely bento lunchbox.
Very cute.
And we have sort of like these little shish kebabs, and they have everything you need to have a balanced meal, really. It's the protein is the chicken, and you have gluten-free bread, and you have all the vegetables. All I did was skewer it. My husband did remove the tips, so it is no longer dangerous. Okay? And so you have a balanced meal. You have protein, you have fat, and you have your good carbohydrates, which are the vegetables.
And kids love presentation.
Yes, and they would love to put those together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's a fun thing to do. And
you
it's healthy.
Did you do this the night before? Because I know a lot of parents, I mean, I do the night before.
Yeah.
So.
Oh,
okay,
anything,
good.
Yeah. You know, another good thing, too, is like protein shakes. You could freeze at night.
Oh.
And then it would be just the right temperature when they're going to have their lunch.
Okay, very
And
good.
That would be really fast, too.
What is this?
Those are kale chips, organic kale chips, which you can buy in the store, or, of course, you can make them yourself. It's really quite easy. So it's very well-rounded, very balanced. And then to sort of shift gears, I went to the farmer's market yesterday and got grass-fed organic
jerky.
Delicious.
I think that's part of the problem. A lot of people are like, what do I do for protein?
Because, that's a protein. I'm big on protein because it regulates blood sugar and helps keep the kids focused. So, and keeps you full and satisfied throughout the day.
Okay.
So that's really important. And also, I bought this at Whole Foods. It's turkey jerky, and it has no nitrites, no nitrates. It's in the form of like sticks.
Okay.
Almost like, like the Slim Jims of the past, but very healthy.
Slim Jims
of the past
are
very bad,
for
but
you.
The healthy version.
Yeah. All right. Now, you made little
salsa
cups.
These are so fun. Yeah, and I think kids would love this because it's layered. And this could be vegetarian also. So you have the beans on the bottom for the protein, you have the guacamole for the fat, and then you have salsa, and then I just put like some scallions and diced tomatoes, and then these are quinoa and sweet potato chips.
Oh my goodness.
And they're delicious. You'll have to try some.
Now, Judy, a lot of people are saying, I would love if my kids eat this. They're young. They don't like new things. How do you get them to try these things?
I think when they see their parents eating healthy, it sets a good precedent, and I think that if you have good food around and they see you eating it, I have grandkids. I always use them for guinea pigs, and like they would look at stuff and be a little bit horrified, but then they'd taste it because they're curious, and they actually love it.
So and it takes time for them to develop a taste sometimes.
It
okay.
does. You know,
we're just about out of time, but I want to make sure we get to these goodies.
Okay, I want to say muffins can be healthy because you can make them gluten-free.
Okay.
These are made with almond flour, and I have like 3 cups of zucchini in this whole recipe.
Oh, my gosh.
Carrots, lots of carrots, and even if you want to do fruit, and you can always add protein powder to the batter to get more protein. And if you aren't doing
is
nuts.
Is protein powder okay for kids, little kids?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, good to
know. Unless they have different types of protein powders. You can get whey, you can get hemp, you can get egg. So, I mean, if they have a specific sensitivity, you can always find one that will work for them.
All right.
So there's always ways that we can combine these. And these are yummy little apple slices that have sunflower nut butter and coconut and pumpkin seeds and a little bit of cacao nibs.
We are all ready for breakfast here. I don't know. Forget about packing the kids for lunch.
Oh, we didn't have to make your little thing, but okay.
I know. We just ran out of time, but thank you. Such great ideas. Are you sharing those recipes with us?
Are
we sharing them? That would be great because I think some parents are probably watching saying, how do you make that?
That's a great really way very simple.
All right. Judy, thank you so much.
My pleasure.
Great ideas to get a healthy lunch or snack in for the kids.